bomb gets nothing effect. Has that one taken away by Troy Hellman. It seems like this could be...
All right, guys, this is Brick My Victory here with Owl Recap. We have another player interview today. We have Krystal from Hangzhou Spark. Today they beat London 3-1 in the stage quarterfinals. Congratulations. First question, in an earlier interview this week, you said that you felt very confident going into the match against London and thought you would beat them. What gave you such confidence?
第一个问题, 在之前的采访, 你说过了, 对上伦敦非常有信心, 然后有胜算, 是什么给了你这么强的信心?
因为我们最近训练都在练33嘛, 都在练这个阵容, 然后打得还可以, 然后也有一些特定的战术, 然后在伦敦这场去使用, 然后我觉得我们的, 所以我觉得我们会有胜算。
Because we practiced the 3-3 composition recently a lot, and we have certain strategies, and we utilized those strategies in today's match, so we think we have a decent chance against London.
Due to the victory today against London, you guys are now scheduled to play San Francisco in the semifinals. Do you guys think you have the same level of confidence going against San Fran?
所以赢了伦敦之后，我们下一场对上的是震动队。你觉得对上震动队，我们会有同样的信心吗？
我觉得我们还可以把我们的，我觉得只是我们这样的表现还是不够的，因为震动要比就是要更加的厉害嘛。他们创造了OWL最高连胜的记录啊，然后包括今天他们也就是被上海龙先拿了一分，然后后面三场打得非常的漂亮。我觉得我们应该比这场做得更好，才会有机会去战胜他们。
So we think keeping our current performance is not enough because the San Francisco Shark is a little bit stronger than the London Spitfire. They have the longest winning streak in the OWL history. And beside the first map today, they have a really good performance against the Shanghai Dragons. So we think we need to play better to win against them.
A few weeks ago, your team was a part of the homestand for Dallas. What about the homestand did you like, and are you excited to play for the fans in China next year?
之前我们是在达拉斯打客场的队伍之一，然后在达拉斯的体验你有什么特别喜欢的？然后你对之后回到中国打主场比赛有没有什么感觉感受？我觉得在达拉斯第一是达拉斯的主场非常的好，然后非常的大，然后能容量很多的观众。第二就是我觉得德州的烤肉非常的好吃，然后在达拉斯有每天有不一样的就是新鲜感吧，因为之前都没有去过这个城市。
So regarding Dallas, the first of all, and their arena is really big. It hosts a lot of audience. And second, the Texas barbecue is really tasty. And last, because we give us something new because that's a different arena. It's not like the experience we have at the Blizzard Arena here.
That's really funny that you said that you like the Texas barbecue because OGE famously said that he likes Korean barbecue better. I got to ask then, do you like Korean barbecue or Texas barbecue more?
你提到这个德州烤肉，因为OGE之前说过了，他其实更喜欢韩国烤肉。然后，那你是更喜欢韩国烤肉还是德州烤肉？我觉得我更喜欢德州烤肉吧，因为德州烤肉就跟韩国烤肉完全不一样，是两种风格嘛。然后我觉得我更喜欢德州。
So Krystal actually prefers Texas barbecue. He thinks that Texas barbecue is a totally different style from the Korean barbecue. It's just like Texas barbecue better.
No offense to Korean barbecue. I love Korean barbecue, but I'm with you. I like Texas barbecue better. Next year, you guys will be playing home and away games. What do you think is going to be the biggest advantage about playing at home in China? And what disadvantages do you think the travel is going to provide teams next season?
So 明年要打主客场，你觉得在中国 粉丝
面前打比赛会有什么样的优势？然后，因为明年主客场会有很多的旅行，你觉得这样会给我们带来什么样的劣势？我觉得在中国主客场这个形式的话，我觉得会有很多的中国粉丝去到现场加油的。然后，我觉得这是对我们帮助其一。然后，第二，我觉得这个经常的长途飞行的话，确实会对自己有一些影响，因为每个地方都时差都很不同。然后，但是 像什么足球联赛、篮球联赛也其实也是这种主客场的形式，每个城市都每个就是每个地方的主场，然后我觉得这样也是蛮 OK
的。So I think going back to China to play home games there, there will be a lot of Chinese fans cheering for us, and for this advantage, I think we definitely will experience some disadvantage because there will be a lot of travelings, there will be time zone differences, but I think that's something we can overcome because all the professional sport leagues, that they have to travel a lot.
There's been a lot of talk about a potential change to the way Overwatch is done with a 2-2-2 role lock system. What are your opinions on the system, and do you think that would be good for the game of Overwatch?
所以现在有很多的关于讨论，就是说，以后选人要每个角色选两个，这样锁定住嘛。然后你觉得这样对 Overwatch 这个游戏有什么影响吗？
嗯，其实我觉得就是 Overwatch， 然后这个游戏最大的精髓就是在 H 键去换英雄，就是对面拿什么阵容，然后我们拿什么阵容，就是有一个克制关系的。然后如果说就是锁定22的话，其实有很多阵容还是拿不出来，然后也缺少了一定的就是观赏性吧，也缺少了一定的就是团队配合呀，更多的研究战术之类的东西。我觉得还是以就是现在这种情况，可能会是比22要好。
So the spirit of an Overwatch game is the you can press H and switch heroes, and if we are locked to the 2-2-2, and we cannot choose certain heroes, and we cannot choose to do certain strategies, I think that the current system is better because it allows us to use certain heroes and certain strategies.
It creates more versatility within the roster.
这个阵容有更多的这种多样性，对吧？
Last question then. If there's something you could tell your fans about yourself they may or may not know, what would it be?
如果你要告诉粉丝一个他们可能知道或者不知道的事情，你想告诉他们什么？
嗯，就是我用的这款鼠标，因为暴雪规定嘛，要全新的鼠标，然后去带到联盟，然后去检查才可以在比赛中使用。然后我这款鼠标是非常已经停产很长时间的一款赛瑞 King 组，然后很难在市面上找到全新的，已经费了很大的力气，然后才找了那么几个，所以说我很苦恼。现在就是以后啊，如果说以后要换鼠标，这款鼠标如果说实在是没有找不到，停产很久找不到新的，然后要怎么办？
So Blizzard has a really strict peripheral policies for players' mouse. They need to have they need to be unopened, brand new ones. So Krystal actually use a certain model that's out of production for many years. So it's really, really difficult to find brand new ones on the market. So Krystal actually having some troubles worrying if that you cannot find brand new ones in the future, what we have to do.
Worried about a gear issue then. That's interesting. That's the first time we've had an answer like that. Well, that's it here from Al Recap, guys.